start with some nice slow froggies to get warm. Dropping down, full extension up. Welcome to workout number 76 on the CLEO method. I'm Kirra, I'll be your trainer today. Keep moving through these lovely froggies to get nice and ready for a really good full body workout. All you need is a set of dumbbells and a good playlist. So pop that on. We've already organized one for you. All right, now we're going to come into a nice hip opener. So walking your hands out into a nice high top plank for me. I want you to push back. Your right leg's going to bend and extend and take it over to the left. So we're getting a nice hip opener and just hold a couple of breaths if you can. And then taking that right foot down, let's go left leg, bend and extend. Twisting over to the right, hold and breathe. Driving those palms into the ground, get nice and warm. Coming back to center. Let's take your knees as wide as the mat now. Sitting back into a nice child's pose. Then we're gonna rock forward into a push-up. Let's start to get the muscles flowing. Child's pose, beautiful stretch. Into a push-up. Good, sinking right back. Lovely. Let's go. Two more after this one. Sinking back, child's pose, stretch it out. Nice and low on your push-up. One more here. Sink back. Pushing up, lovely. Coming back into a four-point kneeling position now. We're going to do a nice thread the needle to get some rotation in the spine. So take your right arm up nice and high and extend it underneath, thread that needle, shoulder blade to ground, opening back up and threading through. Lovely. Go two more here. Open and thread. One more. Open, thread, and swapping sides. Left arm now. Let's go. Opening up, thread the needle. So eight exercises, and we've got three rounds to get through. Really effective workout, nice and simple. So if you're up for the challenge, grab some little bit heavier dumbbells. Otherwise, whatever you've got handy. Thread. Unhook those hands. Let's go back to four-point kneeling position. High top plank for me. Slowly walk your hands back in towards your feet. Let's start to stack the spine one vertebrae at a time. Big shoulder roll at the top. Let's grab one dumbbell. We're going to get into the workout. Okay, into a nice squat hold for me. Extend the arms long. We stay in our squat hold. We extend the arms overhead and we come back down. Now we're staying in our beautiful 90 degree hold, as if you're sitting on a seat. The quads are already burning for me. We've got 45 seconds on, 5 seconds off. Set yourself a little goal. I want you to work for that 45, especially on these full body ones, which they all are today actually. Extend, exhale to extend. Inhale to lower. Hold on, we've only got a few more here before we move on to the next. 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab your other dumbbell on the way up if you can. We've got a nice lateral lunge. So feet are nice and wide. Let's take the lunge over to the right first to begin. Dumbbells come down. Then we alternate. So we've got another leg burner. We're really working the inner thighs a little bit more now. Very good. Keep flowing and don't lose that depth. So we're trying to really get low. Glue those dumbbells together. If you need to, you can drop to one. And just keep moving and breathing. Nice. That's it, guys. Stay moving with us. You've got last 10 seconds here. We can get our breath back in a second. 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, next we've got a shoulder press. So we're gonna stagger our stance. Let's take the right foot back. Dumbbells are at your shoulders and we're gonna alternate. So let's start with our right arm. Let's exhale, press, inhale, lower. Strong movement. So the core is always on. We harp on about it, but it's so important. Pull the belly button into spine. Exhale to press, inhale to lower. Try not to let those elbows sink down for me. I want you to have the elbows up in line with the shoulders. Good one to get your breath back, but really focus on your technique and your form. Nice work. Keep moving. Be strong through those shoulders. Staggered stance just challenges the core that little bit more. Last couple here. Then we're on the ground. Two and one. Well done. Keep those dumbbells. Let's lie down for me. Now we're going to start with our legs in tabletop, arms above the chest. We've got a chest fly with legs lower. Both legs are going to extend. So let's open the arms up, extend the legs long, bring them back together. The lower you can extend those legs, the more of a challenge on the core, okay? If you need to, you can just do a fly if you're feeling any lower back discomfort, or if you're just getting back into training. Otherwise, you're with us, or another regression, alternate your leg kick. So only one at a time. Otherwise, we're back on the double. Good. Open and extend long. Point those toes. Well done. Keep moving. Let's go one more rep here and bring it back in. Lovely. Let's drop those weights. We are onto toe tap abs now. So we're going to have our hands directly above the chest, legs in tabletop. Let's start with the right leg. So we slowly take the right leg down and tap. Very slow and controlled. We're just alternating which leg we do as we go. Good job. If you want a challenge, we can go for a bit of a double leg, which we did a few days ago. Otherwise, we're back to your alternating toe taps. You choose your level. This is your workout. Challenge yourself. We've got three rounds to do today. So feel free to pick the pace up as we go and get used to each exercise. Keep alternating for me. Keep doing your double if you are. Cores on, cores imprinted. And time. Great. Okay, this is the exercise of the workout today. So reverse tabletop. So your fingers are facing away from you. Let's extend up into our tabletop. Now we're going to have our right leg long. We hinge down for a crunch and extend. Two. We're going to do 10 on each side. Three. Four. Make sure the hips go down and up. Five. Six. Chest lift. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, swap sides, so keep up in your tabletop, left leg long, toe pointed. Let's crunch down and extend. One, two, lift those hips up. Three, four, five, good job. Keep moving. Eight, lifting high. Nine, 10, rolling the spine back down. Great work, guys. If you can't get through 10 in that exercise, that's okay. Just make sure you do swap legs halfway. All right, into a nice kneeling position for me. We're going to go into a bicep curl into a rotator cuff. So your arms always stay at 90, okay? So let's go for bicep curl, rotate, curling in your rotator cuff movement. Good, so external rotation. We're trying to keep those elbows in nice and tight to the rib cage. Don't let them flare out. We want to get the maximum benefit, especially for those rotator cuffs. Very important for your shoulder strength and stability. Keep that breath flowing. Breathe out as you lift if you can. Otherwise, just focus on the movement. We've got one more in our set before we get a rest. Good. 10 to go, and then we're on our feet. Good. Stay strong through those biceps. And time. Well done. All right, standing up. We're going to face on a nice angle. Stagger the stance again for me. We're going to stick with our right leg back just for this first round. And we're going through dumbbell punches. So exhale, push. Push. Good. This is where you can really challenge yourself, okay? So go nice and quick as we are here. The girls are excited. Otherwise, find your pace and stick with it, okay? Your one goal for us all is to go for 45 seconds because we've got that 30-second rest after this exercise. Oh, feel the burn. 15 seconds to go. If you need to, add in your little pop, whatever gets you through, your little bounce. Last little push. Keep going. Chase down that break. Four, three, two, and one. Whew. Okay, dumbbells down. We've earned that one. Nice hydration. Break, round one done. We've only got two more to go. Great work, guys. As I said in the first round, we've done all eight. So two more rounds to go, two more opportunities to challenge yourself. If you're up for it, choose a heavier weight. Otherwise, you can always pick the tempo up or choose one of the options that I've gone through, okay? So one dumbbell to start with. I was getting excited. We're gonna start with that squat hold overhead raise, okay? Two, one, let's go. Squat, arms out, let's extend. If you found the first round a little bit harder, don't worry. Round two, you're nice and warm. So you find you may be a little bit better this round. So truly try, focus on whatever you're doing. This is it, this is all you need right now. And that 45 second push, okay? I know you've got this. It's getting warm in here, good. 15 seconds to go. The burn is on. We are on fire too, 10 seconds. Exhale to lift, inhale to lower. One more rep, and time. Whoa. Great work, guys. Okay, lateral lunge here. So feet are wide, we've got two dumbbells. They are in the middle. So let's go to the right side first, and then we alternate. Remember, this one is a lovely exercise. You can pick the pace up if you're willing, but don't lose that depth, okay? We don't wanna go fast and lose our form. Get low, well done. Over halfway through. Remember, you've got the shoulder press after this. So stay low, good job. Last little push, you're nearly through. Feel those adductors, those inner thighs working hard, and time. Well done. Staggered stance again. Now we are going to take our left leg back for round two. Arms are up, let's start with our left arm, press. Right arm, press, good. Whenever you start to get a little bit heated, go back to that breath. Things start to get a little bit heavy, go back to the breath. So you should always be exhaling on the hard part of the exercise. That's the best way to remember. Well done, team. Keep pushing. Stay strong through those shoulders. Don't let them slip up to those ears. We've got 10 more seconds here. Dumbbells up, good. Two and one. Well done. We're down. Chest fly, legs lower. So let's focus on the imprint of the spine. That's our goal for this one. Ready? Let's go. Opening up for the fly, extending legs long. Good. Remember your aggressions here. You can kick one leg out or you can stay in tabletop. Otherwise, you can also kick up a lot higher. That will take out a lot of the load on the lower back. But remember, we're all about the challenge. I believe in you. Imprint that spine and extend. Slight bend in the elbows for your fly. So you're basically unhugging the tree, re-hugging the tree is the analogy I love to use. Exhale to extend. Good job, stay with us. And time. Okay, toe tap abs, so dumbbells are to the side now. Tabletop legs, arms above your chest. Let's go right leg lowers to tap onto the left. We're going nice and slow, control, imprinting the spine. So belly button down to the mat. Well done. Doing awesome, guys. Keep that core on, nice and slow and controlled. Often much more effective than speeding it up. I know we want to sometimes to get it done. Good work. And tap. Last couple. Let's go one more on the left. And time, okay. Exercise of the workout, here we go. Palms, fingers are facing away. Let's lift up. We're going to go right leg long. We crunch and extend. We've got 10 to do here. Two, three, hips up. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Point the toes. Nine, 10. Let's swap. Stay up in your tabletop. Left leg goes long. hinge, two, one, two, that is, three, can't lose a rep, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. We're gonna do three more on each side just because it's round two. Ready, let's go. One, two, three, let's swap, three on this side, one, two, three. We couldn't let that time get away. The girls in the studio are probably unhappy with me. All right, back to our bicep curls. So start at your 90, we curl, turn, curl. Well done. So if the heart rate's up a little bit, bring it back. Back to the breath, strong through the biceps. Shoulders are back as well, don't let them round forward. Dumbbell punches after this and we're at the end of round two. Good job. That's it, team. You've got 10 more seconds on the curls and we're up for a nice fast one. Our punches to finish our round out. That's it, that's it. One more full rep in. Curl, rotator cuff, curl. Well done. We are up. Dumbbell punches. We're going to have our right foot forward, our left leg back. Staggered stance, bending the knees. Let's go. Punch, punch, punch. That's it. Dumbbell should be punching straight above those eyes, okay? So straight out, straight above the chest. Don't let them drop. We're setting our goal. This is all for you, this lift, 45 seconds. Chase down that break, it's coming. 20 seconds left. Okay, stay with us, keep them up. I know this is where it's burning, we're feeling it too. 10 seconds to go, hold on. Don't break now, you've come this far. Three, two, and one. Whew. Dumbbells down. We've only got one round to go. Amazing work. Don't forget to hydrate. Nice protein-rich meal after this, whether it's breakfast, dinner, lunch, whatever it is, make sure you've got some good protein in there. Okay, so one dumbbell to start with. We've only got, this is it. This is our last round. Okay, so remember our first one, we're at the 90. We've got our overhead raise. All right, let's do it. Last round, let's come to our 90 degrees. Our arms are out. We extend, lower, extend, lower. Good job, nice. Well and truly warm. We're already sweaty. So round three is going to fly by. We're deep in the workout. Exhale, extend, inhale to lower. Find your range, okay, with your overhead. If you can, we want to go as high as possible, but only lowering down just below that chin. You've got another 10 seconds. What a start to round three. Hold on, we're fighting. Four, three, two, one. Whew. Shake it out, shake the legs. All right, lateral lunge side to side. Legs are out, toes are turned a little bit. We're gonna go to the right and to the left, to the right and to the left. Last time on each of these exercises. Good job. Focus in. Let's get the job done. Over halfway now. Good momentum, keep up your pace, keep up your flow. Don't worry about what's next. This is all you need to focus on right now, your lateral lunges, okay? Get low. Only a couple more to do. Three, two, one. Jumping up. We've got our shoulder press. So we're gonna go back to staggered. Let's take our right foot back as we did in the first round. Okay, right arm press onto the left. Good one to get the breath back, even for me. Good job. Strong through those shoulders. Nice work, team. Keep moving. Alternating. Don't let those elbows creep down by your side. Keep them up. 10 to go. Punching directly above your head. Let's go two more. Last one. Whew. Roll them out. We are down for our chest fly, legs lower. Okay, so rolling the spine down, tabletop legs. Let's open the chest fly, extend long. Nice. Exhale to extend, inhale to come in and tuck. Remember your options as I discussed in rounds one and two, but this is your last opportunity to challenge yourself. Choose your challenge. Good work. Stay strong, especially through that core, okay? Full body exercise. The core is the most important one in this one. Imprint your spine. Belly button down, all the way to the mat. Let's go two more reps here. Last rep. And time, good job. Dumbbells down to your side. Toe taps abs. So arms above your chest. Let's take your right foot down. Left leg. Very good. The further away you tap your toe, the harder this little challenge may be, okay? Keep that slow tempo. Don't get caught up going fast as your breath may be. Good job. Slowly tap. Good team. Almost there, last couple. I lied, you've got another 5 seconds. Good, 3, 2, and 1. Time, hug those knees in. Our reverse tabletop leg extension, okay? Hips are up, right leg's long. Let's tuck and extend. 1. Point the toe, 2, 3. Squeeze the glutes, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Lift up, 10. Good job. Stay high. Alternate to your left. Hinging, extend. Good. Crunch, extend. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We've got to do 5 more on each side. Last round, why not? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can do it. Last 5 on the left. We've got to even up. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Well done if you kept up with us there. Really good challenge. Back to our bicep curls. 90 degrees. Let's curl. Rotate and curl. Well done. Definitely your favorite, those little reverse tabletop knee extensions. Absolutely everything working. Good team. Slow that breath down. Dumbbell punches after this and we are there. So fast. Good. Shoulders back, elbows in. Curling up. Last couple of reps. Curl, rotate, curl, let's go. One more bicep and time. We're standing up, dumbbell punches. Let's go, right leg back, we're back to the right leg. Arms are up, let's go. Punching. This is it. Absolutely last exercise of workout number 76. I know you've got this. We're not gonna drop on this one, okay? Don't worry about whatever's happened in the rest of the workout, the rest of your day. Let's go, we've got this. You've got 20 seconds on the home stretch. Long punches, straighten those arms. Don't drop, you're so close. This is it, 10 seconds to go. Cool down's approaching. Keep them up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo-hoo-hoo. Okay, dumbbells down. Come to the end of your mat for me. We'll do a little spin. 3 big arm circles for me. So hinging it, bending at the knees, extending up. Oh, get that breath going. Let's go again. And down. Last one. Bending and up. Well done. Let's start to roll the spine down. We're going to come out into a nice high plank. We're going to go into a pigeon stretch here for the glutes. So let's take your right leg forward. Leg should be horizontal with the mat, your shin. I want you to stay upright for me. Take a big inhale. As you exhale, let's lower down. Find your range as low as you can. Doesn't matter if you're up here, wherever you're feeling that glute stretch, okay? And let's hang down here for a few breaths now. Give yourself a pat on the back, a round of applause. What a workout. Good job. Palms back to the mat for me. Let's extend up. Untuck that left foot back to your high plank. Let's swap. Left leg comes parallel with your mat. And take staying upright. Inhale. Let's exhale. Let's get down into deep into that glute. Find your range. One side may be a little bit more stiff than the other. That's completely okay and completely normal. Slow that breath down. You deserve a really good stretch after that. All right, palms back to the mat. Let's unhook the toes back to your high top plank for me. Now we're going to sink knees back on the mat. We're going to go back into a nice adductor stretch actually. So let's take your left leg out long while we're here. And all we're going to do is just sink back into a nice adductor, so your inner thigh stretch, and then rock forward. Sink back and rock forward. Again, find your range. We're just trying to open those hips up a little bit. Especially if you sit a lot, you're running around with crazy kids all day, whatever you're doing, hip mobility is very important. Let's go one more, rocking forward here, back to your kneeling position. Let's go right leg out and hinging back, rocking forward. Good. That inner foot, the medial border of your foot, should be touching the ground. Good. Find whatever works for you. No doubt you're still getting a good stretch. Let's just go one more here. Well done. Knees back on the mat. Let's sink back into one nice big child's pose here. Knees are wide, sinking back. Push those palms down to the mat. Long inhale and exhale. Nice calm state. Ready for whatever's ahead. Restful sleep, work day, whatever it is. Slowly come back up for me, back to seated if you can. Well done, guys. Thank you for joining us for workout number 76. We'll see you tomorrow for some more fun. Thanks.